Dave, a lot of hard work there, wasn't it? Not the result you were looking for in the end, was it, for all that pressure?
Got a point at Accrington, got a clean sheet. Going out of here very frustrated because I think the sending off actually kills the tempo and the momentum of the game, and it didn't suit us. And you know, we tried everything to try and score, and got a lot of forward players on at the end. And you know, at the times you've got too many bodies, you know, in the way. And to be fair, they put the blocks on the line, and you've got to give Accrington credit for the way they defended for me. Very resolute, very determined. But it's that clean sheet that they wanted to hold on to, and they did do so. A lot of credit goes to Accrington, and you know, we're going to have to work at our game in that final third. As I've alerted to all season, you know, it's something that we are going to have to polish up a little bit.
Did you make the keeper work enough from your perspective, really, for all the pressure?
I'm going to have a look. You know, I'll have a look. I'm emotional now, so I don't have to sort of go too much into it. But, yeah, I'm going to look at it and see how many times we've made him work. And in that last third, I think he's pulled off some very good saves. You know, and only from the start of the game, only one team really wanted to win this football match. And we've dominated and dictated with 11 men and with 10 men, but not scored.
How much did that sending off change? You alluded to it. They were lopsided to begin with, and they made a change at half time. But how much more difficult did it make it? Does it change mentally, the approach?
I don't know if it changes mentally. I just think from a tactical point of view, you know, the passing style that I want to play, we got more effect with Clive, you know, diagonal balls into Clive. And I don't think the players switched early enough to work out that. And they've got to get more street and more savvy into working out that there's two different ways to win a football match, and that's what we've come here to try and do. And you know, we're improving. I see us improving, there's no doubt about that. And you know, I was here Friday night when they've carved Scunthorpe open a couple of times, Accrington, and they offered nothing. With 11 men or with 10 men, they offered nothing in attacking play. But I do think it just, the balance of the play shifted, because there were so many bodies centrally that we had to try and get round or get through or get over, and we didn't have the creative craft to do that.
Was there an element, you think, of the hangover of not playing so often in the last couple of weeks, in that lack of craft?
Potentially, that last little bit of sharpness, potentially, it's something I alerted to with the players after the game. And you know, that'll come, you know, a little bit of rust off us, a little bit of, you know, a little bit of blow the cobwebs off, and then we'll go again. So, you know, we're frustrated in there, but tomorrow's another day, and we'll look to move forward in all aspects of our play.
You gave the strikers a go tonight, didn't you? Everybody had a run. That must have been something you had in mind? Four strikers,
yeah,
on at one
know,
point?
At times, you do your planning before the game to certain players and why you're making them sub and why they're utilising them as subs. Was always going to put Platy on, you know, he's an offensive weapon. I felt that pace could upset and unbalance the movement. In the first half, some of the football we played were brilliant, and it'll get overlooked and get missed. And we created better chances probably when they had 11 men.
And, it's a faster pace, wasn't it, the first half?
Miles faster pace. So, you know, I'm pleased with a lot that's happened tonight. But again, you know, we've come for 3 points, like I'll go everywhere for 3 points, and at home, that's what we go for. You know, we're not playing to for a draw, we're not playing not to lose. We play to win football matches, and that's what we've done again tonight.
Does this change your plan going forward? I know it's very quickly after the game, but when you look to Saturday, do you see things that to approach differently?
Nope.
Different opposition?
Absolutely no change. You know, it's a bigger term vision than just, you know, people keep saying, are you going to stay in the league and all that, carry on, you know. We've got so many games left. We're building something here. And, you know, managers who panic, managers who lose the plot, change what they're trying to do 6 weeks into something they started. So I'm certainly not going to lose the plot right now.
But not the question of just one game at a time, as the old adage says. You're looking a bit further than Wimbledon, for example.
Well, I'm looking 2 years time, absolutely, at this point. That's what we've come for. So you know, we're looking at everything to try and improve everything football at the club, and we'll get better, and we'll just continue to get better all season. I'm convinced of that.
How much has your squad come on for that run, though, percentage-wise, from where they've been and been having to train?
Again, I don't know. Until I've assessed it and evaluated it and got the detail and the data back, then, you know, I'll pass for judgment on that, because we don't know what it has impacted on them. But they have trained and trained and trained and trained, and match sharpness. It's a bit like a pre-season. I mean, Danny Mayer's not played for 5 weeks. Some of the players haven't played for 3 weeks. A long time not to play. So we're out of a bit of rhythm and out of sync, but there's certainly improvements being made in this team all the time.
I think it's at times in the second half, it was like a training exercise, wasn't it? 11 against 10.
Yeah, you know, you do get that, and then people start just flapping a bit, and you know, that snatching, I think that's a good word to use. You know, and a bit of anxiety, and you want to win so bad, the lads are frustrated, they've not played for a while, and that a little bit anxious and snatching at the shots instead of really getting hold of it and gripping the shot. So, you know, I get it, I really do get it. You know, I've been wired all day to try and get a result, and you've been frustrated about seeing other teams sort of go past us, and the players have definitely felt that, so a little bit anxious, and we'll work on that.
There was times, a lot of times in the second half, when every person by Jensen was in the Yaki half. We had no ambition at all after the sending off, did we?
Listen, I don't think they have much ambition to start that game. They couldn't get the ball off. So with 11 men, with 10 men, with the sending off, I don't think it mattered. We've come here to win a game of football, and we've done everything possible to win a game of football, and we haven't done. But credit to Accrington, because there's a lot of brave players who've put themselves on the line. A lot of blocks. The keeper's been fantastic, and is a top-class keeper. And, you know, they've kept a clean sheet, but it's not for the want of trying.